We are here today. Both as county government of Marsabit and Kenya Red Cross Society, the Secretary General is here with a host of staff from both Nairobi and Marsabit. We are here to assess, we came here to assess the state of drought. As you could be aware, Marsabit is the most affected counties in terms of the challenges of drought. We've lost quite a number of livestock, over 60%. The serious challenge of water. People are also starving. Most schools are closed. The challenges are beyond the capacity of the county government to manage at the moment. We appeal to Kenya Red Cross Society, and we are privileged to have them here today to do what's called a livestock offtake, to slaughter the remaining few livestock so that the individual families can get money to buy food. And those who do not afford can now take the meat and supplement, you know, with the grains that the county governments and other donors are giving.
So the fact that we are here today just goes to show our commitment to wanting to alleviate and empathize with the community and with the county government throughout the country. Anyway, we know 23 out of 47 counties are facing drought, and the numbers even then will continue climbing.
Well, since the drought has started, the livestock has reduced something like 60% in this place. And most affected ones are the shorts and donkeys. Even the county government has started giving food before, and we expect even more. And there's also something like things like cash transfer, which the governor has launched today here, from both Red Cross and also from the county government.
Number one worry is the food, and number two is water, because human being cannot reach water from 30-40 kilometers, and the donkeys they use have died, the camels have emaciated. We have 7 primary schools in this ward and 1 secondary school, and all our schools are at the verge of closure because teachers cannot send children, students, pupils and students home for fees. They cannot send them for, and the 7 primary schools are boarding, and the secondary school is also boarding. They are no food, they are not getting food.
I guess what needs to be done now is to put all our resources together as a nation to address the needs of the most vulnerable in these communities. As you've had here, close to 60% of the heads of animals in this county have perished. And with the continuation of this drought and severe weathers, more are likely to lose their lives. So the action we are doing today is simple. By buying these animals, as we call animal destocking, from the animal owners, the pastoralists, is just to give them a bit of a break and a bit of a hope, in the sense that they are not struggling on their own.